We are broadcasting live, and I'm trying to bring Mike Cutler up on the council here. Mike Cutler, as you all know, is a former DEA agent. INS agent, and worked with DEA. Testified before the Senate committee on the 9/11 Commission. Hey, Mike, how you doing? Mike? Oh, boy. I'm going to have to tell Mike to call back in and see if we can pull him up. Let's see here. See if we can pull him up. Oh, here we go. Get him off there. See if I can get him on the line for us. Here we go. He'll call in and hopefully... things are working, you know, but I want to talk a little bit about sanctuary cities today. Hey, Mike, can you call back in? I just disconnected you because I can't get. No. I understand all that. Call back in. Thanks. Yeah. So anyway, we're working to try to get this system up and running. President Trump spoke out today on sanctuary cities and how people need to respect the law. They do. They need to respect the law. That's what we're talking about here. People respecting the law. People doing the right thing. But liberals want to usurp the law, accept the laws that they think they should obey and that they should respect. And the bottom line is we don't need it. We don't need liberals telling us what we need to do. We just don't. We don't have time for it. And that's what they tend to do. They try to get you off center, get you off square, so that you're dealing with their nonsense. And let me just say this, it is nonsense, all of it. Hey, let's take this call. Here's Mike. Let's see if we got him in the system now. Hey, Mike, how you doing? Mike, can you hear me? For whatever reason, I cannot bring this call into my system. It's the most amazing thing. Let's see here. If I can bring Mike into the system, because I hear him. Mike? Man, I cannot bring you into the system. Okay, this is what I'm going to do. I'm going to disable everything except for your line. Let's see here. So I'll go recording, playback, disabled. And sorry about this, folks, but you know, sometimes these technical things get like this. Disabled. Let's see here. We'll disable that. Hello, Mike. Can you hear me? Okay, recording, disable, a playback. Let's see if we can, have we disabled everything? Nope, I'm gonna disable this. Maybe this will force the, Mike, can you hear me now? Hello, Mike? I guess he can't hear me. I don't know what's going on with the system today. Let's see, maybe, I'm just looking for the setup and maybe it's wrong out here. Let's see, Arizona, political, yada, 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 connections, contacts, call log, detail, admin. Okay, numbers, media. Oh boy, I just can't make it work. I don't know what's happening. But anyway, we're going to go ahead with the show. And I'll tell Mike that I just couldn't get it to work today. Don't know what's going on. But I'll let him know. But we'll continue talking about President Trump, talking about sanctuary cities. We just can't get it to work. Don't know what's going on. Hey, Mike, I don't know what's going on. I just can't get the system to pick you up. I can't get the system to pick you up, and I'm on the air, so I got to go. Talk to you. Thanks. Bye. Anyway, sorry about that. But that's what happens when you're, you know, running a system like this. I need to talk to the administrator. But look, we're going to continue. I wanted Mike to talk a little bit about sanctuary cities, but, you know, we have a mayor from Los Alamitos, and he was on TV earlier today talking about sanctuary cities and the problem with sanctuary cities, and that, you know, the governor and the administration, has put he and people like him in a very precarious situation because they refuse and they don't want him to follow the law. What kind of craziness is that? They don't want to follow the law, uphold the Constitution. You know, it's just amazing to me that these folks are so lawless. And then the first thing they want to do is stand up and accuse Republicans of being lawless. And they refuse to follow the Constitution. Constitution is very clear. Immigration is under the purview of the president, President of the United States. California, and if you listen to people, they tickle me talking about how California is another state. I think we fought a civil war over states trying to secede from the Union. We fought a big war. We lost about 500,000 Americans. That war was fought from 1861 to 1865. We lost 500,000 Americans almost. That was just the ones that died on the battlefield. We're not talking about the ones who died at home from infections and various other wounds. But here we are again fighting this battle over immigration. This is what I don't understand about immigration. Immigration has always negatively impacted Black Americans. In fact, we had stopped immigration from the 20s up until 65, when Ted Kennedy decided that and pushed forth an immigration bill of 1965. What this bill basically did was stymie and halt and stall the integration of Black Americans into mainstream America in favor of immigrants. I remember an immigrant man coming over. His name was Mr. Linford. Mr. Linford lived across the street from us. He moved into a new house across the street. And he was from Germany. Well, as a young boy, you know, 11, 12, 13 years old, and watching movies about the Nazi and how we hated Nazis and we hated Japanese, and seeing this German move across the street, man from Germany. He was from Germany. He spoke English with a very thick accent. He was from Germany. The Pontiac Motors had brought these guys in as tool and diamond tradesmen rather than to train Black men and other Americans. But they were training white guys. They just couldn't train enough of them. And they refused to train Black men for these jobs. It's really interesting that 4 years later, a friend of mine's father became a tool and diamond through a program that Ford Motor Company implemented, and Chrysler had the same program, where they encouraged folks to go to junior college, community college. They paid for it, and they trained them on the job, OJT. So let's listen to what this sanctuary, this anti-sanctuary city lawmaker has to say. He's the mayor of Los Alamitos.
Here we go. What we're going to tell them is that there's a lot of people in California that that want a rule of law. They want us as their city council members to uphold the Constitution and work with the U.S. immigration officials. And, you know, I also tell them that, you know, we have the third largest California National Guard base in our city. And I've talked to the soldiers, and the soldiers are wondering why we won't get out and be a part of this process with the president.
Sure.
Wow. See, the military, contrary to If you look at Obama, Obama's always trying to hang out with the military. The people in the military hated Obama. You see these stupid black people running around trying to get a picture with the president. They're just stupid. They have no morals. They have no values. They have no guts. I'm sorry. President Clinton, I didn't like him. I didn't like his politics. I don't know whether or not I would have tried to get a picture with him, but when I saw him, and this is why I kind of poo-poo these people who would run up to Obama who were in uniform, he has captivated me. You know, the guy won me over. In fact, my wife was saying, well, I thought that you were going to punch the president out, talking about Clinton. I'm like, no. In fact, this is the deal when I met Clinton. It's a true story. Met him at Juanita Jordan's birthday party. He and I were talking, and he put his head on my shoulder. I put my head on his shoulder, and we were laughing so hard. I can't remember what we were laughing about. I swear to God. And so when I came back and was talking to my wife, she was looking at me like I had three heads, right? I'm going, what's wrong? She said, you and the president were hugging. And I'm like, yeah, he's a great guy, you know. But, you know, she did the same thing when she went to the White House and met President Bush. She was gushing and walking on cloud nine talking about how she was going to vote for President Bush. And I said, wait a minute, you don't like Bush. She said, I do now. I can change my mind. Oh, man, you love it. You have to love it. But, you know, here's a mayor of a city who certainly knows what he's talking about and says, wait a minute, we need to support the president. We need to get behind the president on this. And yeah, we do. We certainly do. And we're going to. Now, the California AG, a guy who needs to be indicted, I think he's so criminal, Becerra. He wants to be the next governor. Oh, God. Hey, you people out in California, don't vote for this Mexican, okay? I mean, this guy is obviously more concerned about Mexicans than he is about Californians. Now, you can say that's racist. You can say that's stereotypical. You can call it whatever you want. It's just a fact. But Sarah is more interested in helping illegals and bringing Mexicans into California to take over California per La Raza's claim than he is anything else. That's who he is. It says here that the California Attorney General, Xavier Becerra, has been adamantly opposed to local officials working to opt out of the sanctuary law. State law is state law. But, you know, Becerra, who's supposed to be an attorney, tries to claim that state law usurps federal law. We all know that's not true. Well, we may not all know it, but it's true. Federal law supersedes state and local laws. That's just a fact. And the president has the responsibility and the purview of what? State law or federal law. And he can claim that, like on immigration, you know, he could set the immigration policy. That's what he is entitled to do per the Constitution. Becerra says state law is state law, and it's my job to enforce state law, and I will do so. So we want to make sure that every jurisdiction, including Orange County, understands that state law requires of the people and subdivisions of the state of California. When Becerra was asked if his comments meant a potential arrest or lawsuit against Orange County Sheriff, Becerra responded, I just think I answered that. Ooh. Becerra said on Hannity's show that he, or I should say Barnes, sheriff or Orange County Sheriff said on Hannity's show that he took Becerra's words as threatening, but hopes he understands that the law that was passed allows the publication of inmate information, meaning they publish the release times of inmates and illegal aliens. Da-da. Hey, look, we're gonna take a little break. We'll be right back with the Reality Check with Charles Butler. Stay tuned.
Red State Talk Radio is now available as a voice command on your Amazon Echo and Echo Dot by simply saying, Alexa, play Red State Talk Radio.
Red State Talk Radio on TuneIn.
Turn to every single American. Now, we've been hearing all these stories about sanctuary cities that...
You can now find us on the Amazon Echo and Echo Dot, on TuneIn, on iHeartRadio, and we also have the phone apps in the App Store for your particular phone. And just in case we activated your Echo Dot, Alexa, stop.
Hi, you want to end those expensive cable bills for good? At VIP TV, we offer unlimited HD quality streaming of over 900 channels on 5 devices at the same time for $39 a month on a pay-as-you-go basis. You can watch it on your big TV with Amazon Fire Stick or TV, Roku, Comcast, Android, gaming consoles, as well as laptops and tablets. You can use an HDMI cable to connect PC to the TV or smart TV via Wi-Fi. Once you've enjoyed the benefits of VIP TV, you can sign up for the service as a customer or business partner with a customized website, $39 or $59 a month. Visit ordervIPTV.com/the reality check. That's ordervIPTV.com/the reality check. Any questions, just email us at therealitycheckviptv@gmail.com. Stop wasting time and money and sign up now. Cancel cable for good.
Hey, this is Leonora Cravota from Red State Talk Radio for MyPillow. I used to have trouble sleeping. MyPillow changed all that. I now fall asleep within moments of my head touching my pillow. That's how comfortable MyPillow is with its patented interlocking fill. MyPillow stays cool and does not go flat. Plus, it's machine washable and dryable. MyPillow has a 10-year warranty and a 60-day comfort guarantee. MyPillow is also the official pillow of the National Sleep Foundation, and it's made right here in the USA. MyPillow is now offering Red State Talk Radio listeners a 4-pack special with 2 premium standard or queen pillows and 2 go-anywhere pillows. That's 4 pillows for the price of 1. To take advantage of this special offer, call 1-800-961-9194 and ask for promo code Red State. That's 1-800-961-9194, promo code Red State. Put sleepless nights behind you with My Pillow, the most comfortable pillow you will ever own.
For the best night's sleep in the whole wide world, visit MyPillow.com.
Little compared to what there. Hey, I tell you, amazing. So, California is under siege. The number of cities that do not support the sanctuary city law put forth by old Jerry Brown and Becerra and all of these other pseudo socialist. That think they can usurp federal law, and somehow state law usurps federal law. Sorry, it doesn't. Like I said, we already fought the Civil War over that issue. Oh, man. Makes you want to holler the way they do my life. I think, my guy, what's his name? Marvin Gaye, I think he hit that well. Makes me want to holla. Makes me want to holla. I tell you that, the way these people try to do our lives. But this sanctuary city meeting that Donald Trump had today with folks that are against the sanctuary city laws of California. We'll see a turnaround. We'll see a change. The change is coming. And people are fighting to uphold the law, the Constitution, and they are not bending to these liberals, to these radicals, to these people who want to change the complexion of America. I can tell you this, I don't want any browning of America, because I know that those black people in Mexico and further south catch hell from the lighter skinned people. And we here in America don't, black folks don't like Latinos, and Latinos don't like black folks. See, that's what's not said. That's unspoken in public, but it's certainly talked about in private. People always say to me, well, you know, Charles, it's not that I disagree with what you're saying. It's just that, why are you putting all our business in the street? That's a phrase that's used in the black community for telling white folks what black folks are thinking. So, sorry about that, but, oh man, you know, crazy Maxine, crazy Auntie Maxine, you know, there's always that crazy relative. And this woman, she tickles me. She is so bizarre. She is so insane. She's been running around now for the last almost 2 years saying, impeach the president. Impeach 45. We gonna impeach 45. And I go, impeaching for what? I mean, see, you have to understand a couple of things here. Maxine is not a lawyer. She's not an attorney. I think she's a teacher by profession. She's a big mouth black woman. She hasn't passed any legislation that's any meaningful for anyone, including her district, which is mostly Hispanic now. Her district is like a war zone. She doesn't even live in her district. She lives in Hancock Park. Hancock Park is a very exclusive neighborhood. It's kind of like La Jolla to San Diego or Beverly Hills to LA. It's one of those kind of neighborhoods. Hancock Park, Beverly Hills, you know, smaller houses in Hancock Park, not as expensive, but, you know, Beverly Hills, Hancock Park, you know, Bel Air, very upscale neighborhoods. That's all I can say. So she, Maxine Waters and this guy named Representative Kelly, they get into it on the House floor about Maxine, you know, basically trying to divide the country. So let's listen to this clip a little bit. I'm going to make my comment. Here we go.
We are doing the same thing every day that you are doing. We are trying to make sure that we're making America great every day in every way. And the best way to do that is to stop talking about discrimination and start talking about the nation. We're coming together as a people in spite of what you say.
I am more offended as an African-American woman than you will ever be. And this business about making America great again, it is your president that's dividing this country. And don't talk to me about the fact that we don't understand what happens on the automobile. No, I will not yield.
Wow. That was an interesting exchange. Maxine says, I'm not going to yield. You know, I don't have to follow the House rules. What rules? They don't apply to me. I'm Maxine Waters, of course. Auntie Maxine, there's always a crazy relative.
Yeah, she will, perhaps. Our next guest made headlines.
And this guy, you know, Kelly, I think he's from Philadelphia. He's a rep from Philadelphia or something. But the point is, though, that these two lawmakers were battling and they were debating if the automotive industry discriminates against women and people of color. And the answer is, of course it does. So Kelly says, stop talking about discrimination and start talking more about the nation. And, I agree with both of them, actually. But Maxine, see, my thing is simply this. I'm talking about giving people who are qualified, more than qualified, an opportunity. Maxine Waters is talking about race. I'm talking about people who happen to be black, who've been denied access to opportunities on a business level, on an emotional level, on a financial level, because of the color of their skin. Maxine's talking about some damn social programs. As a matter of fact, but see, and that's the problem. That's where we differ. You know, I certainly concur that there's racism and discrimination in America, but I would throw into that, you know, the most racist people I run into are Latinos, white women, Democrats, and liberals. I need to jot that down because I need to put that in my book. And pretty much in that order. I don't like them. I think that they're self-serving. I think that they're parental, deferential, paternalistic. I could go on with these adjectives, but it wouldn't do any good. But I think that Maxine and Maxine, you know, she constantly discredits herself with her antics. And this is the same woman that claimed the CIA was putting drugs in the black community. Well, that happened to be true. But in order to prove that, all she had to do was to let this young man testify who'd gone to prison for dealing drugs, and he was put in business by the United States government. This is a truism. His distribution system was designed by a Harvard MBA. And I remember reading back in the 80s, sitting at my desk at Hewlett Packard, never forget this, an article talking about the distribution system of the Bloods and the Crips, the drug distribution system could have been designed by a Harvard MBA. Well, in reality, it was, okay? But Maxine discredits herself because she refuses to deal with the facts. She wants to deal with emotion, and that doesn't work. Doesn't work today. It's over. As a matter of fact, Rahm Emanuel, they said, threw ice water on Maxine's claims to impeach the president. I mean, it's stupid. The other person that's stupid is that guy Al Green from Texas. I always say they need to, that Texas state needs to revoke his law degree. And I'm very serious about that. Uh-oh. Here we go. Got another break coming up. And I need it. Grab some water. So look, we'll be right back. By the way, we're out here broadcasting today on Facebook and doing our thing out there. Hope you enjoy the show. Hey, yeah. Trigger Happy Policing. So we'll be back soon as this break is over. So stand by.
Hi, you
want to end those expensive cable bills for good, at VIP TV, we offer unlimited HD quality streaming of over 900 channels on 5 devices at the same time for $39 a month on a pay-as-you-go basis. You can watch it on your big TV with Amazon Fire Stick or TV, Roku, Comcast, Android, gaming consoles, as well as laptops and tablets. You can use an HDMI cable to connect PC to the TV or smart TV via Wi-Fi. Once you've enjoyed the benefits of VIP TV, you can sign up for the service as a customer or business partner with a customized website, $39 or $59 a month. Visit ordervip.com/the reality check. That's ordervip.com/the reality check. Any questions, just email us at therealitycheckviptv@gmail.com. Stop wasting time and money and sign up now. Cancel cable for good. Okay, folks, we're back, and wanted to kind of talk about something that no one else is talking about. And it's the Poor People's March. It's the Poor People's Campaign. And, you know, it's really interesting that this is not getting much media attention. I think it is. And you would too if you knew what it was. So let me kind of break it down for you. The okay, so let me kind of break it down for you. Let's see. This guy, his name is William Barber, Reverend William Barber. I never liked this guy. Everything that I read about him, have seen about him, he worked for the NAACP. He was a chapter president in South Carolina somewhere. Not a good guy, in my opinion, you know, very detrimental to Black Americans. And, you know, this is what he's doing. He organized, unfortunately. It says in this article, this is an article that I pulled out of the Washington Post, and it's dated from Monday or the 16th. Is that today? The 16th, that's today. And this article by a guy named Eugene Scott says, it seems to be constant conversation in the media and among politicians and their audiences about the middle class Americans are being impacted by the current economy. But a group of liberal activists, politicians, and others are reviving a campaign created by Reverend Martin Luther King Jr., looking to draw more attention to how current economic policies affect poorest Americans. Okay, so this month-long protest movement called the Poor People's Campaign, a national call for moral revival. Well, if you're going to have moral revival, the first thing you have to do is to push this LGBT agenda into the closet. However, since most Black pastors will tell you that most of their money comes from gays or homos, what you gonna do about that? They're not gonna touch it. The moral revival. You know, these people are anachronisms. They're living back in the 60s. We need to be talking about jobs. We need to talk about building Black businesses. You know, this moron and people like him are so stupid, they don't get that these Indians have taken over all the Dunkin' Donuts. If you're Black or white, you can't go buy a Dunkin' Donut franchise. You have to be an Indian because they control all that. Dunkin' Donut gave that up about, I think, in the 90s to these Indians. You know, when you look at franchises for hotels, all the low-end stuff, Ramada and some of these other hotels in that low-end budget area, the Indians have gotten loans for those. And I'm not talking about Native Americans. I'm not talking about American Indians. I'm talking about people from India. And where did all these people come from? Every last one of them have a damn hotel almost, or their own business subsidized by the American taxpayer, when black and white people can't get loans. Okay. So we talked about donut shops, hotels, startup companies. If you let Zuckerberg tell it, an Indian is the most intelligent person in the world. That's a damn lie. If it were, how come their country's not great? If it were, why are they over here? How come they're not in India? Why, if India's so great, why didn't they go to an Indian university instead of coming to America? Because Americans are fascinated with anyone who has color except for the American Negro. See, when we talk about Negrophobia, that's a real phobia. And there's a book out called Negrophobia. I think you need to check it out. You can buy it online. It's at Amazon. It's in your libraries. Negrophobia. That is the only real phobia that we have had in America. There's no such thing as Islamic phobia, homophobia. It's all BS. Wow. But this whole poor people's campaign, a national call for moral revival. Moral in what way? Let's bring jobs back to America. Let's put people to work. Let's start saying to these black women who are having babies out of wedlock, having babies on a damn booty call, having babies without a father, and proud of it, let's say to them, it's immoral for you to have a child out of wedlock. It's immoral for you to bring a child into this world without its daddy involved. And by the way, if its daddy wants to be involved, he will marry your fat behind. But, you know, at the end of the day, when you look at a lot of these black women or American women, period, who in the hell would want to spend the rest of their life with a sultry, combative, angry, Miss Andre Layton American woman? That's why I always say, behind closed doors, when we're talking about kicking out the Latinos, I'm talking about all those fake macho dudes with the scraggly beards and the straight hair. Leave the fine women. Now, all the fat women, short, fat, wide, gotta go. But those fine Latino chicks, leave them right here. Like J-Lo, leave right here. Okay. You know, hey, you know, this is the thing about jokes, man. People today are so sensitive. They want to be so politically correct. And they're not politically correct at all. They're not PC at all. In fact, they're very intolerant. A young man, if I can pull this up, this young man wrote a Trump, what do you call it? A Trump invitation to his girlfriend, right? To this girl. And it was really cute, I thought it was really cute. And they got on social media and they castigated the guy. But he was like, I hope I can find it. But it was so cute. I thought it was funny. But people got upset and they're, you're hurting people's feelings. The hell with these people and their feelings. I always say this about that. How many people been called the N-word? Not many. Well, you know, and that word can have power over you if you let it. That's what I always say. When I was coming along, that word had a lot of power. Today, not as much. But it could have impact on some people, and some people take it very seriously. I don't. I wish I could find that little deal that boy did. Maybe if I go to history, it will allow me to pull up this Trump piece. But this kid, he was so cute, I thought, in asking this girl to the prom, and they castigated him for it. And he's like, you're a racist. And the kid was just being clever, I thought. Maxine Waters, here it is. Trump theme prompt proposal. Yeah, here it is. This is really, I thought it was cute. And I thought it was cool. I thought it was very creative. So this kid, he's in Wisconsin. He's a high school student. And he had this Trump-inspired promposal. And it triggered all this debate on social media and in his community. It says the unnamed student at Eisenhower High School in Berlin, Wisconsin, asked a classmate to a prom with a sign that read, "Will you make my night trump all others and let me deport you to the prom?" What's wrong with that? It is so cool. It is so creative, I thought. A photo of the sign was posted online, but it was taken down after receiving dozens of comments, many of them critical, and some students quickly came to the defense of their student. Since obviously it's a kind of current issue, but it's not something we thought people would be taken aback by, said a student who's a friend of the sign's creator. It kind of makes me feel sad because I know the kid personally, and I know he didn't mean any ill will towards it. I mean, deport you to the prom? I mean, hey, illegals need to be out of here. They need to be deported. I'm sorry. I don't care about their feelings. I don't care about the DACAs. I don't care about the Dreamers. Their parents broke the law. So if my parents go out and rob a bank and they happen to be here from another country, I'm supposed to get put in the front of the line for citizenship. I'm supposed to be given scholarships ahead of American children. No, hell no. And you people out there need to be pissed off and angry if it means taking to the streets. Now, I'm on the verge of calling for an armed upheaval and revolution. These politicians I'm standing in a government building agency today. And the receptionist is saying that, you know, she's asked this guy if he spoke Spanish. I mean, if he spoke Spanish. Not if he spoke English, if he spoke Spanish. Why are we catering to these people? Why are they here? When you go to France, do they ask you, do you speak English? No, no parlez-vous français, you just SOL. You go to Rome, there's nobody around in the government building to say, well, do you speak English? No. No, and let me say this about that. There are really only two languages that you need to operate anywhere in the world. One is English and one is French. Not German, not Manchurian, not Mandarin, not Cantonese. English and French. That's what the Chinese use to communicate in, French and English. Man, it's amazing. But you know, Americans are so dumb because they haven't traveled anywhere. They don't know anything about anything except America and very little about that. Uh-oh, here we go. We'll be right back. The Reality Check with Charles Butler.
Red State Talk Radio is now available as a voice command on your Amazon Echo and Echo Dot by simply saying, Alexa, play Red State Talk Radio.
Red State Talk Radio on TuneIn.
Turn to every single American. Now, we've been hearing all these stories about sanctuary cities.
You can now find us on the Amazon Echo and Echo Dot on TuneIn, on iHeartRadio, and we also have the phone apps in the App Store for your particular phone. And just in case we activated your Echo Dot, Alexa, stop.
Hi, you want to end those expensive cable bills for good? At VIP TV, we offer unlimited HD quality streaming of over 900 channels on 5 devices at the same time for $39 a month on a pay-as-you-go basis. You can watch it on your big TV with Amazon Fire Stick or TV, Roku, Comcast, Android, gaming consoles, as well as laptops and tablets. You can use an HDMI cable to connect PC to the TV or smart TV via Wi-Fi. Once you've enjoyed the benefits of VIP TV, you can sign up for the service as a customer or business partner with a customized website, $39 or $59 a month. Visit ordervIPTV.com/the reality check. That's ordervIPTV.com/the reality check. Any questions, just email us at therealitycheckviptv@gmail.com. Stop wasting time and money and sign up now. Cancel cable for good.
Hey, this is Leonora Cravota from Red State Talk Radio for My Pillow. I used to have trouble sleeping. My Pillow changed all that. I now fall asleep within moments of my head touching my pillow. That's how comfortable My Pillow is with its patented interlocking fill. My Pillow stays cool and does not go flat. Plus, it's machine washable and dryable. My Pillow has a 10-year warranty and a 60-day comfort guarantee. My Pillow is also the official pillow of the National Sleep Foundation, and it's made right here in the USA. My Pillow is now offering Red State Talk Radio listeners a 4-pack special with 2 premium standard or queen pillows and 2 go anywhere pillows. That's 4 pillows for the price of 1. To take advantage of this special offer, call 1-800-961-9194 and ask for promo code Red State. That's 1-800-961-9194, promo code Red State. Put sleepless nights behind you with My Pillow, the most comfortable pillow you will ever own.
For the best night's sleep in the whole wide world, visit mypillow.com.
Okay, we're back and hanging in here. Got to watch the time because time really gets away from me being here. You know, sometimes in the show a little late, but you know, you can go out online and catch it either at Facebook or YouTube. But this month-long protest, this People's March, you know, I mean, that's what I'm talking about. People getting bent out of shape about, you know, comments. Let's talk about this poor people's march, because everyone else is talking about Trump's immigration speech. They're talking about North Korea pulling out of the peace talks. They're talking about what's going on in Gaza and Israel and yada, yada, yada. We're not getting anywhere because people don't care. Just like people don't care about the poor people's campaign. You haven't heard about this, but 200 people got arrested on Monday. 200 people in Washington, D.C. That's not counting all the people who got arrested in all the state capitals who are on this poor people's campaign. A national call for moral revival. Well, they could start with a moral revival by telling these gays or homosexuals that they need to get right with God. A virulent anti-homosexualist is what the Media Matters calls me. That's too funny. The event was launched this week with hundreds of protests across the country, including a rally on the U.S. State Capitol lawn. And here's what you should know about it. What is it? Over the next 6 weeks, thousands of Americans are expected to participate in protests in 35 state capitals and Washington, D.C. The events are a continuation of protests organized in 1968 by King in response to the shortcomings of the Johnson administration's war on poverty. Hey, idiots, that was 50 damn years ago. 50 years ago. 50 years ago, all of the black millionaires, or let me correct that, erase that. 50 years ago, all of the Negro, let me repeat, quote unquote, all of the Negro millionaires used to be listed in Ebony magazine every year. And what some of the men who appeared on that list told me was every year they would be audited because they were on that list. John Johnson put that together. And he was one of the millionaires on the list, by the way. But 50 years ago, the Poor People's Campaign asked the federal government to invest $30 billion into helping poor Americans by demonstrating commitment to full employment, guaranteed annual income measure, and more low-income housing. The most recent iteration of the protests seeks to address issues related to restoring voting rights, and the implementation of federal and state living wage laws commensurate with the 21st century economy, an end to mass incarceration and racial inequalities for Black, brown, and poor white people within the criminal justice system, 100% clean, renewable energy, and other issues associated with the modern progressive movement. It's a socialist movement. Who cares? This has nothing to do with Martin Luther King. This is a socialist communist movement by any stretch of the imagination. I'm sorry, but McDonald's jobs weren't meant to feed a family, pay rent. The financial construct of paying employees at McDonald's, it's a part-time job, not a full-time job with full benefits, health insurance, 401k. Yeah, the money's not there in a McDonald's to do that. Man, these ignorant ass people, I tell you. And this barber is one ignorant guy, believe me. In a protest Monday outside the U.S. Capitol, a group led by Barber and Theo Harris blocked traffic, eventually leading to the arrest of 146 protesters by the Capitol Police because they knew they were going to be arrested because they were blocking traffic. They didn't have a parade permit on the whole nine yards. Just ridiculous. Ain't nobody going to turn me around. Shut the hell up. They're an abomination to the civil rights movement and to what we consider what's going on. Hey, we got about a minute. Tomorrow I'm going to do a little bit more on this Poor People's March and do a little bit more research. But I think it's an abomination. I'm going to write a piece on it this afternoon, and I think it's a slap in the face of the people who went before and who were there in 68 when lynching was still prevalent, when a Black man couldn't get a fair trial in America. Hey, Rodney King, where are you when we need you? Johnny Cochran, where are you when we need you? Martin Luther King, where are you when we need you? These people have gone absolutely bonkers with their socialist progressive agenda. Hey, look, take care. Take it easy. Have a great one. We're going to be back same place, same time tomorrow. Take care. Bye-bye. That's the real show. That's the show that's up on Red State, but we're going to keep talking. We're going to keep doing our thing right here live. And I want to finish up this piece on this socialist, Marxist, progressive. Oh, man. It's just amazing to me. Eugene Scott. I gotta follow Eugene. I got to tell Eugene, this is crazy. I'm going to reach out to him on Twitter. You know, this barber guy has always been, in my opinion, whacked out. Totally whacked out. So let's see here. I'm going to see if I can Twitter Eugene. I don't think I can. I don't think I can. _ Scott. I don't think I can. Let's see here. Eugene Scott. Eugene Scott. Let me see if I can get him going here. Eugene_Scott. There we go. Yeah, there he is. Hey, man. Hey, man. Put on here the Poor People's March. Is for socialism and liberal BS. We need jobs from China that Okay, there we go. Hey, but Joe Scarborough, I got a note here from Scarborough. It says, congratulations to the entire Morning Joe team. You are the reason we had five straight quarters of record ratings and are on pace to have our best year ever. It's because you're constantly dogging Trump and CNN with that crazy Chris Cuomo and that other chick. Their show is just totally whack. I thank you so much, Joe. Really, Joe? Come on. Come on, Joe. You can do better than that, Joe. Anyway, but I think this March on Washington is misplaced, ill-placed, ill-timed. If anything, this guy should be teaming with President Trump and trying to bring jobs back from China. But instead, he's talking about, we need to punish the white folks. We need to take more money from rich white folks for poor black folks and poor white folks and poor brown folks. Negro, shut the hell up. These people are an embarrassment. They're a disgrace to black leadership. And they certainly don't lead me. And I'm sure they certainly don't lead or speak for a number of other blacks or browns or white folks. Anyway, I'm going to sign off now. We got some running around to do. So pass the video around and try to call me tomorrow. We'll do that. Take care. Okay, let's see here. Hey, man. Sorry, didn't see you. I got to set my stuff up. Did not see you out here. Out there. Let's do it. All right. So anyway, let me end this video and